Hello and welcome to Adelaide. In the past few days, I travelled from Cairns to Adelaide by train via Brisbane, Sydney, Canberra and Melbourne. Both New South Wales and Victoria have extensive rail coverage throughout the state. That's why I had a few options to choose from when going between Sydney and Adelaide. From Adelaide to Perth, however, there's only one way, travelling across the Nullabor with the Indian Pacific. Adelaide, the capital of South Australia, is home to 1.3 million people. It's the fifth largest city in the country and still is an important hub for both freight and passenger trains. The city has two major railway stations. Adelaide Railway Station is served by all suburban trains, and Adelaide Parklands Terminal is exclusively used by the private company Journey Beyond, which operates long-distance passenger trains to Brisbane, Sydney, Melbourne, Darwin and Perth. Adelaide Parklands Terminal has three platforms, which allows it to handle both the GAN and the Indian Pacific at the same time. There's no public transport available directly outside the station, but the nearest bus stop is just a 4 minute walk away, and Adelaide Showground train station is just 800 metres away. Same as the GAN and the Great Southern, there are two levels of service offered on the Indian Pacific, Gold and Platinum. You can translate that to Business and First Class. Being the more expensive service, Platinum passengers receive additional perks such as complimentary private drop-off and pick-up to and from the station, additional checked luggage allowance, a dedicated check-in lane, a more spacious cabin and a better dining experience. The Indian Pacific originated in Sydney the day before and is scheduled to arrive in Adelaide at 3:15 p.m. I arrived at 2:40 so that I could film the arrival of the train. Normally, passengers joining the train in Adelaide are advised to arrive at 5 p.m. This is why there's no one else at the terminal, but the staff was happy to check in my bags already. The Indian Pacific is not a regular commuter train that transports passengers from point A to B. It's a luxury experiential tourism train, which means there are a few off-train excursions throughout the journey. If you boarded the train in Sydney and are heading to Perth, you will have 5.5 to 7 hours to spend on your own in Adelaide, or you can join the following four tours. Barossa Valley and McLaren Vale, both are famous wine regions, Handorf, a charming German-themed village, and the South Australian Museum, which is situated in the centre of the city. Before the train even arrived on the platform, the coaches were already waiting outside the terminal to pick up passengers for their selected tours.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Indian Pacific from Sydney is now arriving on Platform 1. All persons on Platform 1, please stand well clear behind the yellow line.
From Sydney to Adelaide, the Indian Pacific is hauled by two Pacific National NR-class locomotives. Both are painted in the iconic Indian Pacific livery. Today, the train has 26 carriages. They include two power vans, gold and platinum carriages, lounge cars, restaurants and crew quarters. You can tell the difference between the gold and platinum carriage from their windows. Platinum carriage has larger windows and looks more modern from the outside. Until 2016, the train also had red service, which was the equivalent of economy class. It featured both shared sleeper cabins and sit-up seats. Next to platform 3, you can still find some abandoned red service carriages and see what the seats look like. Unfortunately, the withdrawal of the subsidy of the Indian Pacific by the federal government in 2016 made the red service no longer financially viable for the private rail company. Now, the cheapest cabin on the train is Gold Single and costs at least $1,445 to travel from Adelaide to Perth by train. Back in the terminal, passengers who arrived from Sydney have already been picked up by the coach drivers. The train will be deep cleaned and will be ready for boarding at 9 p.m. In the meantime, those joining the train in Adelaide can visit the gift shop and enjoy a three-course dinner later at the terminal. The shop had a wide range of Scan and Indian Pacific merchandise for you to purchase. By the way, I made a review about my Sydney to Adelaide experience on the Indian Pacific last year. You can click on the tab at the top of the screen to check it out. From 5 p.m, the station staff began to serve sparkling wine, beer and other non-alcoholic beverages. And from 6, you can enjoy some fresh South Australian oysters and a range of canapés. There are Spencer Gulf king prawns with aioli and pork loin mini sliders. Both are warm and tasty. At 7 p.m, Jelly Beyond organized a Flavors of South Australia welcome dinner. This pre-boarding event is designed to give those joining the train in Adelaide a taste of fabulous food using fresh local ingredients and world-class South Australian wines.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Where is the Shiraz from?
To start is a tabbouleh hummus entree, followed by shared plates of mains and dessert. The entree has a very mild taste. The staff does not clear your plate between the entree and the main. The concept is that whatever's left on the plate will still complement the main.
So you keep the plates. It's a continuous grazing, so whatever flavours are left on your plate, they'll complement these dishes.
Interesting.
Can't touch them until he's filmed it.
The shared platters have two proteins, Angus roasted beef tenderloin and free-range roasted chicken. Luckily, I don't have to make choices here. Everyone gets a piece of chicken and a slice of beef. They both taste very fresh. The chicken is flavorful, the meat is moist, it was cooked perfectly. The top quality beef was cooked to medium, the portion is generous, I loved both. For dessert, we got a vanilla panna cotta with berry coulis. Boarding commenced at 9 p.m. The Indian Pacific had a range of private cabin types to suit everyone's needs. The gold single was perfect for solo travelers. It's the cheapest cabin on the train. During the day, the room features a single seat which can be turned into a single bed at night. The downside of this cabin is that the toilets and showers are located at the rear of the carriage, shared among 16 gold single passengers. I've already travelled in gold single a couple of times. I thought I should show you a different cabin type this time, therefore tonight I'm travelling in gold twin. This is the most popular cabin type for couples. During the day, the cabin is a three-seater lounge that can be turned into an upper and lower berth at night. Let's have a more detailed look at my gold twin cabin. If you like the bed to be put down in the evening or put up in the morning, you just need to put out the Make Up My Room sign. It works the same way as a hotel room. The cabin features a safe, a rubbish bin, a row of garbage bags, different buttons to control the cabin lights and the music, and a wardrobe with a hairdryer and towels. On the other side of the cabin, the lower berth can become three seats during the day with armrests in between. There's a foldable table with bottles of water, lanyards and information about the train and the excursions. Under the table, you can find two power points. The ladder for climbing up to the upper berth is stored under the lower berth. The per-person price for the gold twin is similar to gold single. It offers great value for couples. But as I'm traveling alone, I had to pay the fare difference for single usage. The gold twin also has a private compact bathroom. It's small, but you don't have to share it with other passengers. This train also has limited accessible gold twin cabins available for those in need. The next level up is Gold Superior. The cabin is twice the size of a gold twin. The lower berth is two-thirds the size of a double bed. There's a separate lounge area with a table and chairs, a TV, a tea and coffee station, and a private bathroom. The most expensive cabin types are Platinum Double and Platinum Twin. Each Platinum cabin has a spacious bathroom, and the cabin is a two-seater lounge during the day that can be turned into two single or one double bed at night. If you would like to know more about the Platinum experience, please check out my GAN video from Adelaide to Darwin. After leaving Adelaide Parklands Terminal, we travelled on Adelaide Port Augusta Railway Line. This standard gauge line first runs parallel to Adelaide Suburban Goola Railway Line to Salisbury before turning north towards Two Wells. Western Australia is 1.5 hours behind Adelaide in winter. To help passengers better adjust to the time difference, the time on the train was changed to Western Australia's time zone after we left Adelaide. This means instead of being almost 10 p.m, it's only 8:30 p.m. The lounge car is still open for passengers to relax and grab a drink. The Outback Explorer Lounge is a social hub on the train. It has different styles of lounge chairs and a TV screen showing the route map and the train's live location. At the front is a bar and a souvenir corner. The Gold Service drink list includes complimentary Australian red, white, sparkling, dessert wines, beers, spirits, juice, soft drinks, and barista-style coffees. I hung the Make Up My Room sign on the door handle before I left my cabin. When I returned, the bed had already been made. Since I have the whole room to myself, I can choose to sleep in the lower or upper berth. I picked the upper one so that I could still use the lower berth to put my belongings. Climbing up the upper berth using the ladder provided was effortless. There's a rail to prevent you from falling off the bed. If you would like to do some reading, there's a small foldable table and a reading light. There's also a train attendant call button and a little built-in space to put small items such as phones and glasses. Each bed comes with three pillows. The duna is soft, warm and clean, and the bed is long enough for me. My height is 6'1". The air conditioning is centrally controlled. If you do get cold, there are extra blankets available in the cabin. Apart from the individual reading lights, the cabin has ceiling lights and night lights. The light switches are next to the cabin door and near the mirror. When all lights are off, the cabin is pretty dark. Good night! Why are the Indian Pacific and the GAN so expensive? Here are some figures. Tonight's Indian Pacific has 26 carriages. Guess how many passengers it carried? Only 174. At 12:25 a.m. Western Australia time, we travelled through Port Augusta. This town is 311 kilometres north of Adelaide. It's the eastern end of the Trans-Australian Railway and the last town that has a Coles, Woolies and 5G reception until Kalgoorlie, which is 1,691 kilometres away. Good morning! We are now travelling through the far north region of South Australia. This area accounts for 80% of the state's landmass, and yet it's the least populated region of the state. The major towns include Port Augusta, Coober Pedy, and Tarcoola. I had a pretty solid sleep last night. I think this thick mattress has made me feel extra comfortable. It's time for a hot shower. The bathroom is compact, but it has everything I need. There are two glasses, all the standard toiletries you can find at a hotel, a wash basin, and a toilet. There's even a cover to keep the toilet paper dry. Additional toilet paper can be found under the sink. The shower curtain actually covers the whole washing area and even the toilet. The shower head is rotatable, but it cannot be taken down. The water pressure is good and the water is hot. I was very satisfied. Thanks to the shower curtain, I managed to keep the toilet and the wash basin dry. The bathroom is just a little steamy and the floor is slightly wet. Compared to Gold Single's shared bathroom, I think I appreciate having a private bathroom to myself, even though it's very small. The train manager gave me a card with allocated dining times when I boarded the train last night. The breakfast is a rolling breakfast, meaning I can go anytime between 6:30 and 8:30 a.m. The hours may sound early, but remember we are in Western Australian time. Before leaving the cabin, I put out the Make Up My Room sign to give the staff permission to enter. For Gold Service passengers, breakfast is held at the Queen Adelaide restaurant. This is a dedicated restaurant car with booth seating and a kitchen. Although we are in the middle of nowhere, the breakfast menu looks hearty and delicious. There are two courses. For entree, I picked yogurt parfait. It tastes like Greek yogurt with mixed berries, almond and hazelnut crumble on top. I liked it. We are currently traveling through the town of Tarkula. This small town had a population of 0 in the 2021 census, but it used to be a junction station of the Sydney-Perth and Adelaide-Darwin railways. Today, while passenger trains no longer stop in Tarkula, the Gan and the Indian Pacific still pass through this town throughout the year. Just outside Tarkula, the line to Darwin diverged from the Trans-Australian Railway line and headed north towards Alice Springs. For the main course, I chose smoked ham frittata. Each main course comes with a few slices of wood-fired artisan toast with Beerenberg preserves, butter and Vegemite. Frittatas are an Italian-style omelette. They are the perfect option for breakfast. You can add whatever ingredients you like in there. I could taste diced potatoes and probably bacon pieces in mine. The flavor is quite good, even without the sour cream. After breakfast, you can choose to grab another drink and chill in the lounge car or return to your cabin. Back in my cabin, the staff have put my bed up, replaced the wet towels with the fresh ones, and cleaned the bathroom. The floor is now dry and it's no longer steamy. I have both Optus and Telstra SIM cards on my phone. Between Port Augusta and Kalgoorlie, my Optus SIM card didn't have reception for most of the way, while Telstra constantly had 3G signal. But it wasn't strong enough for me to refresh my Facebook or Instagram. There's free Wi-Fi provided back in the Outback Explorer Lounge. The limit is 500 megabits per day. I don't think the signal comes from the satellite, so it also loses connection every now and then. Therefore, the best way to kill some time, in my opinion, is to bring a book with you or download some movies on your device before leaving Adelaide. As we continue heading west, trees are slowly disappearing and the terrain is becoming very flat. We are about to cross the Nullabor. The Nullabor Plain is part of the flat, treeless area stretching about 1,100 kilometers from east to west across the border between South Australia and Western Australia. It takes about 12 and a half hours to drive across the Nullabor Plain non-stop. Without many towns along the highway, it remains a challenge to travel through the region by car today. In terms of the railway, this area lies the world's longest section of straight track. From Udia in South Australia to Lungana in Western Australia, this 478-kilometer track is completely straight. After the railway line was built in 1917, several towns were established along this straight track, and they were named after the first seven prime ministers in Australia. The town of Cook is named after the sixth Australian Prime Minister, Joseph Cook.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The time on train is 12 o'clock. This is your journey manager, Lucy, speaking. During our stop at Cook, we do hope that you enjoy the opportunity to stretch your legs. We would like to stress for your own safety, please do not attempt to enter any of the abandoned buildings. Some of these buildings are near condemned and are all unsafe to enter. Whilst we're stationed here at Cook, the train will be servicing our train. Due to the length of the consist, the train is required to make two stops to complete the watering up of all the carriages.
Welcome to Cook. The Indian Pacific will stop here for about an hour, and passengers get 30 minutes to explore this abandoned town. Cook is located over 1,100 kilometres from Adelaide and 1,500 kilometres from Perth. It's 100 kilometres north of Eyre Highway via an unsealed road. The town was said to have a resident population of 4 in 2009. In its heyday, Cook was a major track maintenance and locomotive repair centre on the Nullabor. It even supported the school and the hospital here. The hospital has an amusing catch cry: if you are crook, come to Cook. The introduction of the more reliable diesel locomotives in the 1950s and the privatization of railways in the 1990s saw the town being effectively closed in 1997. Although most infrastructures are abandoned, there still are overnight accommodations for resting train crews, medical supplies in case of a train accident, and diesel refueling and water replenishing facilities for the Indian Pacific and other trains. When the train arrived in Adelaide from Sydney, we saw that the Indian Pacific was hauled by two locomotives, right? Now there's only one. What happened? The terrain from Adelaide to Perth is reasonably flat. One NR-class locomotive is powerful enough to haul the entire 26-carriage train. Between Sydney and Adelaide, however, due to the mountainous terrain outside Sydney, two locomotives are required to pull the carriages up and down the Blue Mountains. Cook is the only place between Sydney and Perth where passengers can have a close-up view of the locomotive. It's already time for lunch after getting back on the train. As the items on the menu are not listed in alphabetical order, I assume that the first one should be their signature dish. The meat in the cold plate include Wagyu beef, chicken and cured kingfish. All the ingredients taste very fresh, and the cheddar cheese and other condiments make the meat flavorful and interesting. I had never had camel before. I was very excited to see what it tastes like, so I asked for a second main dish, camel curry. Unfortunately, there wasn't any camel meat on board, so the dish was replaced by buffalo curry. Look at the presentation. I love it. The buffalo was thoroughly cooked. It was soft and easy to chew. I wasn't sure how to properly eat the papadum, and there wasn't any reception on my phone for me to Google it quickly, so I just broke the papadum into small pieces and dipped it in the sauce. After searching on the internet later on, I learned that papadums are usually eaten before the meal or with the meal. Anyway, both dishes I had were delicious, and I would like to thank the crew for letting me try both.
The name Nullabor was given to this area by South Australian surveyor Edmund Delzier.
and is derived from the Latin word meaning no trees, which, as you can see, is a very appropriate name. The Nullabor Plain is the largest single piece of limestone in the world, honeycombed with caves, rock holes and blowholes, which does not readily support vegetation. This area is of greater size than the state of Victoria, which is also twice the size of England and four times the size of Belgium. The soil is made up of mainly seashells left behind from the huge seas which once covered the desert millions of years ago. As you can see now, it is truly remarkable landscape. The Aboriginal name for the Nullabor Plain is Onduri, which means waterless.
For dessert, I received 3 scoops of strawberry ice cream. After lunch, I sat in the lounge car for a little while finishing my wine. We are almost at the South Australia and Western Australia border. Here we are. Welcome to Western Australia. As night fell, we arrived at another remote town called Rawlina. This isolated Western Australian locality is 5 hours drive away from the nearest city of Kalgoorlie. It's about 50 kilometers from the western fringe of the Nullabor Plain.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Rawlina. All staff, it is now safe to open doors. As we step off this evening, please be wary that it is quite dark outside due to the cloud cover covering up any natural moonlight.
Before 1951, steam locomotives needed frequent servicing as it required a lot of water. Rawlina Station was one of the 4 major stations on the Trans-Australian Railway. It had workshops, a food store and a school. Today, Rawlina is home to Australia's largest operating sheep station, covering an area about the size of Sydney. The Indian Pacific will stop here for 2 hours. In the summer months, when the weather is warm and the daylight is longer, dinner is served on these benches. Watching the sun drop behind us while enjoying the meals must be romantic and memorable. In winter, dinner is served back on the train. But we still get a chance to look around this town, listen to live music and grab a drink while counting the stars above us. For passengers in gold, there are 2 time slots for dinner, 5:30 and 7 p.m. My slot was at 7, so I got to explore the town first before getting back on board for dinner. Dinner in gold service is a 3-course meal plus a canapé. To start, I had a carrot, duck and coriander canapé. For the entree, both the soup and the tortellini are vegetarian. Therefore, as soon as I saw the word duck on the menu, I ordered that. By the way, if you have any special dietary requirements for your meal, you should inform the reservation center when booking the ticket. Where's the duck meat? After rereading the menu, I realized that I had ordered a pâté. Pâté is a cooked meat paste that generally contains liver. I had never had liver before. This was my first try. The pâté tastes slightly bitter, it's very fresh and the portion is great. But I have to admit that I'm not a huge fan. Next time I'll be sure to read the full menu before making my decision. This is such a colourful main dish, and I'm glad this is meat, not another pâté. The 2 pieces of pork tenderloin have a bit of fat attached to the meat. I believe this is a secret to keeping the pork moist and tender. They were cooked perfectly. The sweet and sour caponata added flavour to the otherwise bland pork. The roasted potato skins were crunchy. I absolutely enjoyed this dish. Each main course also comes with a side of green leaf salad. For dessert, I picked the cheese plate. Back in my room, the crew has put a chocolate and a feedback form on my bed. It's completely dark outside, there's not much to see. I think I'm going to sign off early. Good night. Just a bit of behind the scenes. After filming the goodnight shot, I didn't really go to sleep. I still had to charge my cameras, transfer all my footage from the SD cards to my laptop, and then import them to my video editing software. This may look like a two-night getaway to some, but there were a lot of filming and editing involved before you see my final product on YouTube. Around 25 hours after we left Port Augusta, we finally reached the western end of the Trans-Australian Railway. Kalgoorlie is located in Western Australia's Eastern Goldfields region. It used to be the terminus of the standard gauge trains coming from the eastern states. In 1968, the Eastern Goldfields Railway from Northern to Kalgoorlie was converted from narrow to standard gauge, finally giving interstate trains direct access to the Western Australian capital. Today, the station is served by the Prospector train between Perth and Kalgoorlie 9 times a week. Good morning, we are now at Kulianobbing. During the 6 hours that I was asleep, the Indian Pacific only travelled 229 kilometres. The most significant scenery difference between this region and the Nullabor is that there are trees, so many of them.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The Indian Pacific is currently running on schedule. The Indian Pacific is currently passing through the township of Southern Cross, home of the Kapra people. The Platinum Club and Queen Adelaide restaurant are now open for breakfast until 9 a.m. So please make your way to your respective lounge cars at your leisure and see your Platinum host or guest experience manager. Please be sure to place out your Make Up My Room sign to allow housekeeping staff to access your room for cabin servicing. Have a good morning aboard the Indian Pacific.
Southern Cross is located on the eastern edge of WA's Wheatbelt region. This is why we can see the scenery constantly shifts between the outback and the agricultural land. Kalgoorlie is around 650 kilometers from Perth. It will take us 14 hours to get there. We stopped very regularly to give way to the freight trains coming from the opposite direction. Well, the slow journey means that I have two more meals to enjoy on this train. The breakfast again has two courses. For entree, I picked toasted birch and muesli with poached apple. And for the main course, I chose the full breakfast. The scrambled eggs look amazing. Inclusive of the main course is a slice of wood-fired artisan toast with different jams, Vegemite and butter. Yay, cars! I don't think I had seen a car since I left Adelaide. We are now in Meriden, it's roughly the midpoint between Perth and Kalgoorlie. At Hines Hill, we met the Kalgoorlie-bound Prospector train. The current rolling stock of the Prospector are Trans-WA, WDA, WDB, WDC railcars. First entered service in 2004, they have a top design speed of 200 km per hour and a top operating speed of 160 km per hour. The 14-hour journey taken by the Indian Pacific only takes the Prospector less than 7 hours.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the left-hand side of the train, you may have noticed or come to notice a pipeline. This pipeline starts at Mundaring Weir in the hills of Perth and finishes 560 kilometres away in Kalgoorlie, supplying the residents with their most precious commodity after gold, water. Water is essentially the gold extracting process, and a man called Charles Yelvelton O'Connor, a brilliant engineer believed to be believed that transporting water to the gold fields at Kalgoorlie could be achieved. Many problems arose, and his many critics considered him insane in trying to achieve this project. The water was finally turned on in January 1903, but sadly he died before and he never saw his dream become a reality. Because of the distance involved and the fact that Kalgoorlie is 376 metres above the sea level, the water supply scheme was one of the world's wonders of the age.
We are approaching Northern, which is really close to Perth now. Northern was an important junction station with a large yard, signal box and locomotive depot. Today, the narrow gauge line from Gemelling, York and Albany joins the stand gauge line to Kalgoorlie at Northern and they form the dual gauge Eastern Railway line to East Perth. After Northern, it's time for my last meal on the Indian Pacific. I just realized that I haven't had any proper fish dish on this journey yet. To start, I got a pumpkin and saltbush bread roll. The fish was cooked perfectly, the skin was very crispy. Both the minted pea puree and the fish had no seasoning on them. The tartar sauce delivered the essential flavor to the dish. The fish was mouth-watering. I have to say that the chefs on Journey Beyond Trains are really good at cooking fish and red meat. For dessert, I picked the healthier fruit platter option. The honeydew melon tasted just like its name, it was very sweet. Overall, I don't think I could fault anything about the food that I had on this train. I'm sure that I will miss these delicious dishes at dinner time tonight. The journey from Adelaide to Perth is pretty much sleep, eat, relax, eat, relax, eat, relax, sleep, and repeat. It gives you plenty of time to just sit in your cabin and do nothing. You may find this trip boring if you are interested in off-train excursions. However, if you do the entire trip from Sydney to Perth, then you will be able to participate in the tours in Broken Hill and Adelaide. The Gan had the same cabin types and similar menus on board, but the scenery you see would be different. And obviously, the off-train excursions are different too. I think I like both journeys equally. East Perth Terminal is the western end of Australia's stand gauge rail network and the terminus of the Indian Pacific. It's also the hub of TransWA's regional train services to Northern, Meriden and Kalgoorlie, its coach services to the Midwest and Southern WA, and other private coach companies serving all major destinations between Perth and Broome. East Perth is around 2 kilometres from the city. It's well connected by Perth Suburban Midland and Airport Line trains. These trains depart from the platforms adjacent to the Indian Pacific, and once on board, you can get to Perth Station in Perth CBD in just 5 minutes' time. Thank you so much for watching. After almost 2 years of travelling, I believe I have now reviewed every type of long-distance trains operated in Australia. If you find this video interesting, please don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and check out my other Australian train, flight reviews, and soon overseas travel reviews. I'll see you all in my next video.